involved two research projects on restorative justice after sexual violence. In restorative justice, we're interested in what happened, what harm occurred, who was harmed, and whose responsibility is it to repair the harm. We know that the criminal justice system lets a lot of victims down, and there's a lot of accountability gaps for offenders. So I started to research restorative justice to see if this would offer some additional justice mechanisms for victims, and in fact we found that it does. In the Irish study we interviewed 149 people, 30 victims, 23 offenders, 10 of them were in custody, the other 13 were in the community, all of sexual crime. And then we interviewed judges and barristers and solicitors and therapists and NGOs and everybody else. And we asked them, do we think this country needs restorative justice? And we drilled right into that. And the big answer is yes, we do. And we went and did study visits to multiple European countries. We did a global mapping exercise to see what was best practice. Findings from the research are that restorative justice after sexual crime is happening across the globe under the radar. The second is that victims want this. Victims of sexual crime are screaming out for additional justice mechanisms to the criminal justice system. And when we asked them why, victims, why would you want to do this? The victim said, I want answers to my questions. That doesn't even come in the criminal justice system. And then when we asked offenders why would they want to do this, they said that they feel that they would be interested to do something honourable, having done something so dishonourable. In Estonia, we showed a film that we had made on this work, and the Ministry for Justice has invited us over there, and I've now been involved in training some of their staff, and they are now doing restorative justice in sexual violence cases. The film is based on a real meeting between a woman called Alva Griffith and the man who had vandalised her body in a stranger sexual assault. So we had the meeting with this man, and Alva had a phenomenal outcome. Her life has completely changed. She's now an advocate for restorative justice after sexual crime. I mean, Alva and I were on The Late Late Show, and there were something like 650,000 viewers of The Late Late Show that night. And I know Alva had contact following that, and I certainly had contact from victims looking to know how to go about this. Alva and I are now appointed to the global network of Global Council of Restorative Justice. So the word is out there. I would say hundreds of thousands of people are now hearing about this work, and the slow trickle is coming in.